to make a play. Move the chains, tell them get about the way. Move the chains, I'm about to win the game. Move the chains, baby, tell them move the chains. I score up in the end zone, do my dance all on a hater. A mover and a shaker, you an novice, I'm a player. I'm from DC, but I'm running through and sacking like a raider. Two chains on my neck, one for now and one for later. And we don't play fair, baby, we play for keeps. You can pass me up, this is not a bye week. I'm looking for a trophy competition.
With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
This is taken at his four. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line.
What? 380?
33. Pick it up.
19. Check
the hot read. He's coming. Here's the first carry now for Todd Gurley. And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26. The last play got just a yard. Here's second and nine from the 26. They try right side here. Gurley. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35.
And that's a run that'll energize an offensive line. They'll take that one all day long. Fundamental breakdown by the defense. You've got to be able to make plays on the edge.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. This is Mostert. And he'll take this one for about four up to the 40.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. Gonna give this time to the tailback. And he'll push this forward only to about the 42-yard line. 2 yards the gain there, and now they're left with a third and about four for a first.
Brings up third and four.
Mike's 50.
Go 14.
He's heavy on the edge.
From the gun, it's Wilson. He gets it into the hands of Gronkowski. Complete. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. 13 yards there and a Niner first. So first and 10 now in Buffalo territory at the 45-yard line. Now it's Gurley. He takes this for about six down inside the 40.
40.
Now Gurley. And an alley to run. And he'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains. Quite the opening drive march they're on right now.
It looks a lot like what we saw in practice prior to the game, doesn't it? You know, because on that last big practice beforehand, you go through your offensive script, you go through your play calling, you go through all the stuff and establish things, and it looks like it's going like clockwork right now for them.
A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. That loss of three, a rare stumble on a promising drive. Here's second and 13. Wilson. Over the middle, complete. It's Holt, and they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the two. A good pickup there, 21 yards. They're piecing together a nice drive to start this one. Seems pretty scripted and pretty successful so far.
And I think they did it without our help, because you remember when we sat in the production meeting with them to talk about this and, hey, you know, how are you guys going to come out of the gate? I know I offered my help with a few plays, and they didn't seem to want it.
I didn't offer mine.
You know, you were the smart one. Whatever they're doing, though, it's working really well.
So they're backed up to the 3-yard line, second and goal. They'll try and push it in with Gurley. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it. Driven it down the field nicely here on the opening drive, but now it's put up or shut up.
No doubt about it, because to make that type of a drive and ultimately kick a field goal would feel very disappointing. But I'm just wondering, is the head coach thinking, is this four down territory? Might he go for it?
On third and goal, Wilson. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. He was looking for Gronk that time. Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive, first interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts. They'll start here with Jackson. And he'll be taken down for a loss back at the three. That's going to go as a loss of one on first down.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
Vic back around his own goal line. They set up the screen to Bo. Well, that gives him a little room, but not much. A gain of two to the five. And this will probably be the last play of the quarter. No score after one on EA Sports. They'd like to avoid punting from their own end zone so they could use something here on third down. From deep in their own territory, they look to throw. On the crossing route, complete. That's Holt. That's one heck of a third down conversion, a pickup of 39. For an offense that has not found the end zone yet, that's a big play.
There's the spark right there, the big play that they needed. Now they've got to go ahead and finish this drive and put this ball in the end zone.
They run on first down with Jackson. And a good pickup there. He gets about six up to midfield.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between second and four and second and eight and nine. Here we go, here we go.
Vic now from the 50. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And tackled down after a gain of three. Leaves him with 1 yard to go on third down.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
On third down, Dickerson. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. Give him 6 yards in the first down.
That's quite a spot there for his first carry of the game, but obviously they had plenty of faith in him, didn't they?
No question about it. And here, why not go with the fresh legs? Able to push forward, pick up that first. On first and 10, here's Vic. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. A good convergence there defensively, only a yard, and it's second down.
So many things have to come together just right for a screen pass to break for big yardage. The blocking, the timing of the pass to the runner, everything has to fit together just right. But on that play, the defense was able to disrupt things and hold it to a short game.
Throwing again on second down. Vic flushed it. Now Vic strapped. He lost the football. And now this is scooped up by the 49ers. And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line.
When I see a play like that, I come back to risk reward. I don't know about you, but is it worth it at that point, whatever you're going to pick up, to either take the hit and, in this case, lose the football?
So should have gone down. I mean, hindsight's always 20/20, but that's the safe play.
You're exactly right. Hindsight's really never wrong, is it? Because you can analyze it, but I think ultimately you got to look at it as a first option, taking care of the ball, getting what you can, and that's it. Don't worry about it anymore.
It's a gain of a yard, and it takes us to the two-minute warning. 2 minutes on the clock in what's been a scoreless first half. We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll take you to Orlando and Jonathan Coachman. Coach will have highlights and analysis of this first half, one that's featured no touchdowns as of yet on either side.
So his job's a little bit easier for this halftime.
Need to give the coach some highlights here.
Yes, we do.
Now it's Wilson. And the Bills are going to get him as he goes down. Now the Bills are going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. On is the punter, Cook, who sends it away. Good coverage there holds him to just a 2-yard return following a punt of 44. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. Tie ball game, still a little more than a minute to go in the half. The question, can they put something together here, try to take that lead into intermission?
I would have to think that would be the goal for sure. I don't think you sit on anything here. Here's your opportunity, push it downfield. As you mentioned, it's a tie game. So minus a disaster on your part, you've got that in your back pocket. Go ahead and try and get some points and feel great going into the half.
Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's second and 10. There's Michael Vick. Steps away to his left. That one caught by Tyreek Hill. Give him 18 on that one as the Bills are going to have a first down. Now the Bills will use the second of their timeouts as they'll get a chance to talk it over after picking up the first down. First down throw coming for Vick. It's caught by Jackson. Call it a 1-yard gain on the play, and that'll make this a second down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They've become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate.
Trying to get it to Jackson, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Pat Tillman, and he'll get this one out to the 50 to the midfield stripe.
You can easily see the logic. It's a tie game. They just wanted to press it a little bit right before the half, hoping to get one more score.
Now, easy to second-guess the result, but now you have to think after that interception, just a field goal, and they're behind at the break.
Yeah, I think at the half, the head coach just says, look, that's on me. I wanted to press it, but it's because I believe in you guys.
Here's Gurley now, out of the gun. Give him a yard on the run there, and that's going to set up a third down and 2.
I know the speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
So third and 2, this quite possibly 4 down territory, though, if they're stopped. Now they go screen. It's complete. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or 2 shy of the 30. The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Gurley with a little bit of an opening there as he's able to get 5 on first down. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. They run. It's Gurley. And down inside the 15 he goes. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. So with 1 second left in the half, on is the field goal unit. Tucker's kick is good. And we have action on the scoreboard just before halftime. It's 3-0. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. 2 quarters down. 2 still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. These offenses seemingly still back at the hotel for the first half. 3-0 our score as the second half gets underway. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And with the way this offense has played thus far, to be frank, they got to feel pretty grateful to be in the ball game.
I would agree with you totally, because they've done all of nothing offensively in this game, yet they still find themselves in a position on this drive where a touchdown can give them the lead. They need to take advantage of it.
Well, they're still looking for that first touchdown here in the third quarter. All they have so far, the field goal. To throw on second and 10. Vick eluding the pressure right. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down. 40's him up. Here we go, here we On first down, Jackson. And give him about five as he gets this up to the 48-yard line.
Tough first half for him, unable to put up the numbers he's used to producing. But with a guy like him, you and I both know it just takes a couple of explosive touches for him to make an impact on this game and on the stat sheet as well.
On second down, Dickerson. And he's got this one across midfield into 49er territory. Calling a gain of four there, so it sets up a big play here. Third and a yard.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime meetings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That, and now the ball's out. Fumble near midfield.
Wow. That ball gets knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. Almost like, it's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he only manages a couple here down to about the 38-yard line.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right. He's pretty much been completely neutralized. Being chased out left. He's going to take off with it. He'll wind up with positive yardage. It's a gain of three, but now it's third down. He'd had some success as a runner previously on this drive, just not as much space there that time.
Yeah, this time when he pulled it down, they were ready for him, so I think he's going to have to fling a few in order to open up that running lane again.
Complete over the middle. It's Gonzalez. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers' 24-yard line. I don't know what they talked about at halftime. Whatever it was, it worked. They look like a different team here in the third quarter.
Yeah, I doubt that there are very many trash cans that got kicked over that type of a speech. I think what they did was they analyzed what worked in the first half, what didn't, and figured out a better game plan.
A solid run on first down. Gain of seven leaves them with a second and three. So they'll come up after the gain of seven on a second and three. Vic readies to throw, and that is incomplete.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, and as it turned out, couldn't even find his outlet man because of the coverage. It was way too tight, unable to find anyone open.
So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a third and three. On third down, this is Jackson. And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. Give him a couple on the run as it brings up the fourth down.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
And no field goal try here from the red zone. Offense out there. They'll go for it on fourth. They run again with Jackson. And he is not going anywhere. They stop him for no gain. No dice for Sean McDermott in the offense. And the 49ers are going to get the football back. Time to establish the run game here. Gurley. He's at the 50. The 30. 20. 10. Touchdown, 49ers. Todd Gurley. 84 yards. And the Niners are able to stretch their lead. And that run massively increased his production in this game, and now he's over 100 yards.
Break out your calculator, partner, because his yards per carry went up significantly, right? Big-time jaunt all the way to the end zone.
Tucker with the extra point, and the lead grows to 10-0. This will be taken short. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And here we are almost through three quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, because they're not even over 100 yards yet. And in today's NFL, where it's a pass-first league, that is quite surprising. Not many teams patient enough to stick with the run.
He cannot get away. Down down goes Vic. The sack there by J.J. Watt.
You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made, and that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Here's Vic. On the crossing route, complete. That's Holt. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. Call that a very strong gain of 24.
First down, Bill.
Let's go, defense. Let's go, defense. And here we go.
Now a handoff here to his running back. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine. Trying to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. On second and nine, Vic. And that would not to be. It's incomplete. So they couldn't hook up as time has now run out on this third quarter of play. The Bills on third down. They have been superb. 5 for 6 to this point. This is third and nine. To throw, Vic. That's caught by Jackson. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down.
Instead of throwing it downfield, Charles, they just tried to dump it underneath there. You like the call?
I do. I think it's a high percentage play because you get the completion, and what you're counting on is your back to use his legs and his elusiveness to make people miss and pick up the first down. In this case, it didn't happen.
He is going to find Hill here. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. The time to pull out the stops is now, and they convert there on fourth down. Vic now a perfect 8 for 8 to start the second half. Not bad. First and 10. They'll get him to the ground at the 20 following a pickup of 4.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. Now here's Vic. And that is incomplete here.
How about the defensive effort from both of these teams that we've seen in this game?
Would you say it's like a high-stakes chess match right now?
Chess is one way to go. Yeah, I like it.
Okay, the only reason I say that, you feel like they're contemplating their moves before actually making one, and none of them being done very confidently.
Truth be told, I've never played chess, and I know that I'm not smart enough to play chess. Guys like you with your IQ, you can pull that off.
The escapability in evidence there is that one good for 15 and a first. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he's going to get him about 3 yards closer. He's down to about the 2. The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to 2 remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. From the 2 now, second and goal. Vic to throw it. Touchdown, Buffalo. Justin Tucker for the extra point. And they're back within a field goal. It's 10-7 now. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. After the touchdown we just saw, we have a brand new ball game. And now look at the situation. You've got plenty of time on the clock. Defensively, they have 3 timeouts. So do you run the football here or do you throw it?
I think you have that full conversation with your offensive unit. You tell them, here's the situation.
They've got all their timeouts, so we are not going to play this conservatively. We've got to attack them. We've got to make them use those, gain the ground that we need in order to put this game away. If you think we're just going to run it three times and punt it, you got another thing coming.
Yeah, I mean, by the way, also the two-minute warning in play, so essentially four timeouts left.
They have to be aggressive here.
And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. No gain on the play, and now they're faced with a third and one. So here we go, Charles, third down. Any chance you're throwing?
I don't think so. I think you got to keep the clock rolling here.
And they, in fact, will throw it. Man open, it's Moss complete. The 20, 10, touchdown, 49ers. Randy Moss, 66 yards. And the Niners are able to stretch their lead.
Well, it'd be real easy to say that they are firmly in control right now, but I'm looking at your face and I'm thinking I've got to be careful with that.
Well, it's a two-score game. You're inside of 2 minutes. I think you can breathe relatively easily now.
Yeah, you can, but still, you got to stay vigilant. Can't give up anything cheap and easy. That could put you in some jeopardy.
So a very short kick here. This will be taken by one of the up men. And they'll be set up pretty nicely here as they have it up to the 35-yard line. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. They might be thinking this is close to a lost cause here. Got to play it out. What do they need to do?
Well, they have a thought process in mind already, but they can't get ahead of themselves. They know that they need to score quickly.
Yep, two-score game.
Onside kick and get the ball back and then score again, but they can't worry about the last 2 points. The only thing that matters is scoring quickly, then they'll take it from there.
On second down now, it's Jackson. And he'll be out of bounds up near the 45 at the 44. Pretty good running there, 9 yards. Sets up a third and one. An extra DB for the 49ers now on third. Here's Vic. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he is into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. A big play there. 56 yards. As they are now just an extra point away from making this a 3-point game. Tucker able to connect on the extra point. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. So with just over a minute to play, this becomes a make or break onside kick. And the 49er hands team does its job. Fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
And he's going to get this inside the 30. Now the Bills will use the second of their timeouts as the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in quarter number four. They'll run on first down. Dickerson. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line. It'll be a loss of one, and it'll be second and 11. Down to a knee for the 49ers. This one about to be on ice. Down to a knee one more time, and that should just about do it. So the victory here for San Francisco, and it wasn't really always pretty. They had their bumps and bruises, really both sides did, but they did what they needed to do at home to get the win.
Yeah, they really had to grind this one out, didn't they? Because nothing came easy. Every snap was a major league brawl. They had to win at the line of scrimmage, win downfield. They got all those things accomplished. But to win a close one like this, you know, every team wants to be physical. We've heard that a million times, right? But those who are mentally tough, those are the teams that you have to deal with in the playoffs. This was that type of a game.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. The 49ers get the win here at home as we say so long from Santa Clara.